that the wait is over. Love has finally shown her my way. Marry me.
It's okay.
Stay in every
day. Oh, I love her dress.
It's gorgeous.
If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say we.
Please be seated. Well, I want to welcome you here today, this 18th day of May, 2013, to a wonderful celebration. Seems like it's going to be a very jovial celebration. The wedding celebration of Nicole, Patricia, Fabricius, and Daniel Joseph, right back. Dad, and my dad, and Mom. Nicole and Daniel have asked, I thank each and everyone present for being here to share their day. You are their closest family and friends. Today, Nicole and Daniel will start a new journey together as husband and wife with each of you as witnesses. Parents, a special welcome to you. Without parents, this ceremony certainly would not be possible. Being a parent is a lifetime commitment. A parent's job is not always an easy task, yet as you realize, you are the greatest rewards. Today happens to be one of those rewards. Your guidance and encouragement have assisted your children in ways too numerous to mention. The values that were instilled in your children certainly will evolve with every future generation their life touch. Be proud. You certainly deserve it. We present to our mother-in-laws roses as a symbol of love and respect, and as a thank you for providing each with the person you will be sharing the rest of your lives. I would also like to welcome Nicole's grandparents, who I know they feel very fortunate to have with us today. You not only represent yourself, but all grandparents as well. You may take partial credit, but where the celebration actually began, long before either Nicole or Daniel were even a twinkle in their parents' eyes. Thank you so much for your love and support today. Let us take a moment to remember special people, friends and loved ones who could not be with us today. Especially Joan and Ronald Myers and Kay Cligget. These are the people who have assisted Daniel and Nicole to become a part of who they are. They are certainly with us in spirit and will live always, every day, within our lives. I'd like to ask Tyson to come forward for a reading. I want to grow old with you. I want to make you smile whenever you're sad, carry you around when your arthritis is bad. All I want to do is grow old with you. I'll get your medicine when your tummy aches, build you a fire if your furnace breaks. Oh, it should be so nice growing old with you. I'll miss you, kiss you, give you my coat when you're cold, need you, feed you, even let you hold the remote control. So let me do the dishes in our kitchen sink, put you to bed if you've had too much to drink. I can be the man who grows old with you. I want to grow old with you. At this time, let us take a moment of prayer to reflect on all the wonderful things each of us has to be thankful for within our own lives, and also thank the Lord's blessing for the future, Nicole and Daniel. all join with us in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, and forgive us those who have trespassed against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
The longer I live, the more I realize the impact a person's attitude has not only on their life, but on the lives of the people they associate with and the people they love. Attitude to me is more important than past failures or successes, more important than what other people think or say or what they do. Attitude can make or break just about anything, including a home and a marriage. The thing is, we have a choice. We are in control regarding our own attitude. We can choose to embrace each new day in a negative or positive way. We cannot change the past or how other people act. We cannot change the inevitable, but we can deal in the present. Nicole and Daniel have a great attitude. When I first spoke to Nicole and Daniel, I was very impressed. We talked about many things, the people in their lives, and how they met through their surfing escapades, where their relationship has taken over the past 3 years. Nicole and Daniel both have challenging careers, and are willing to work hard to achieve all the goals and dreams that have not always been planned, but somehow have naturally took place within their lives. They just plain love to be together, and it shows. What Nicole and Daniel feel for each other is stronger and deeper, and much more important than anything you've ever known before. I believe you have already become part of each other. Your individual families and friends are a very important part. Your relationship has grown into a strong, bonding type of love that everyone hopes and wishes to find in their lifetime. For you not only love each other, but like, support, admire, are protective, and dedicated to each other in every aspect of your lives. I forgot to say entertain. I know you'll continue to work side by side to make your house into a home. Not only for yourself, but a home that will welcome many. This home will always be filled with warmth, with love, with laughter for the people you love, and the people who love you both so dearly. And the children, I hope and pray, bless your lives in the future when the time is right for you. I believe there are two essential elements for a good, strong, successful, and lasting marriage. Knowing how to communicate, and knowing how and when to spend quality time together. We live in a very busy, fast-paced world. Remember to take time to tell each other how much you care, how much you love each other, as often as possible. Time is such a precious thing. Although time costs us nothing, time holds the greatest value in any life. Time is something that can never be replaced, nor can time ever be recaptured. Try never let it slip away from you. Enjoy time together, so that your relationship will continue to grow, day after day, year after year, with memories only you two will share. Remember, people will never give you time. You have to take it for yourself. Along the path of life, many people never realize they walk this path beside their best friend. They're married to their best friend. As the growth of a marriage goes on, so should the sacred friendship. Growth of a marriage is something that should never stop, because marriages falling in love many, many times over, continuously with each other. Friendship is the strongest foundation that there could possibly be for a marriage. As you take your vows this day, know that your spouse will be the dearest and best friend you will ever have, a lifelong companion with whom you'll be sharing all of the joys and quite possibly a few challenges along the way of your lives together. I'd like to ask Beth to come forward.
The joyful and wonderful adventure of marriage for Dan and Nicole. However, it can also be scary, dark, and mysterious. Few characters have ever faced as many dark and mysterious adventures as Harry Potter. As such, I shall be reading an excerpt from one of Nicole's favorite books. A chilly breeze that seemed to emanate from the heart of the forest lifted the hair at Harry's brow. He knew that they would not tell him to go, that it would have to be his decision. "You'll stay with me until the very end," said Jane. "They won't be able to see you?" asked Harry. "We are part of you," said Sirius. Invisible to the window. Harry looked at his mother. "Stay close to me," he said quietly. And he set off. The Dementor's chill did not overcome him. He passed through it with his companion, and they acted like Patronuses to him. And together, they marched through the old trees that grew closely together, their branches tangled, their roots gnarled, and twisted underfoot. Harry clutched the cloak tightly around him in the darkness, traveling deeper and deeper into the forest, with no idea where exactly Voldemort was, but sure that he would find him. Beside him, making scarcely a sound, walked James, Sirius, Lupin, and Lily. Their presence was his courage, and the reason he was able to keep like one foot in front of the other. Dan and Nicole, remember when the Dementors come, when things begin to get gnarled and twisted, or even when it feels like Voldemort may be at your back? You will always have your family to walk with you, and they will always be a part of you.
Day more treasured and more complete than either of you could possibly send along. I must ask you, have you both come here freely to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Today, Nicole and Dan will actually be tying it up. They'll be making the true lover's knot, which is the strongest knot there is. It will not break. It will only become stronger when under pressure. The rope itself will break before the knot becomes undone. These two cords represent your past, your own individual and separate life before today. As you intertwine your pieces, you are joining your two lives into one, representing the present. The finished knot symbolizes your future, and how your love and marriage will continue to be strong despite any trials life may throw your way. Ah. Definitely not coming about now. Taking the first step in uniting your lives. You now have each other on which to lean, making any journey an adventure, a challenge, a wonderful future together. Marriage is where eternal commitment begins. It is the fusion of two hearts and the union of two lives. As you stand together before you take your vows, notice your hands. These are the hands that will help you through life's journey. These are the hands that will greet you and say, "I love you," each time they touch. These are the hands that will help you through life's journey. These are the hands that will greet you and say, "I love you," each time they touch. These are the hands that will caress you in times of joy and celebration. They will wipe your tears in times of sadness and sorrow. Where there were two hands before, now there are four. And in God's hands, there are even more. May these hands guide you, and love you all the days of your lives. Thank you. their own vows.
Nicole, you are my one true love. I think this happens every day. You are my destiny and my everything. Please, I give you these promises. I promise to give you a reason to say I love you every day. I promise to keep you safe from real and imaginary monsters. I promise to feed you when you're hangry. I promise to hold your hand in the car. I promise to save you every chance I get. I promise to be mysterious as the dark side of the moon. I promise to make you feel beautiful every day. And I promise to always remember that promises mean nothing without asking. I love you all.
I've written a lot of things in my 25 years on this planet. A concrete history paper at Woodward, multiple news reports in college, an educational research project for my master's, and even my Maid of Honor's mythology paper for senior year. But none of those prepares for writing these vows. The more I thought about why I couldn't get anything else, you're the only person who'd ever let me. I know I can be very hard to love. My signature boldly yanked underneath. Well, here we are. I was wrong. In fact, you're the only person who I want to leave me speechless, surprise me, and prove me wrong for the rest of my life. I can't wait to continue writing these stories together. Thank you for coming up with me, not giving up on me.
We can have a round of applause.
I can't be down.
A circle, like a wedding band, has no beginning or end. There's no point of weakness, but only a constant flow of unending strength that travels around and around, as I hope that your lives will continue to do, filled with all the wonderful things life has to offer both of you. Your wedding day. Your hearts are filled with so many hopes and dreams for the future. When this ceremony is over and all of your friends have gone home, this is when your new journey will begin. I hope all of your dreams come true for both of you. I hope you'll always remember how happy you are today. Continue to bring out the best in each other and honor each other for the special gift of love you have brought into one another's lives. I'm glad you have found each other. Remember to share your joys, your sorrows, but most importantly, your dreams. Always give each other the strength to stand, the light to shine, and the shade to rest in. But most of all, love and respect one another's uniqueness, and always remain the best of friends. I wish you both a wonderful journey, always to be shared together. May your marriage be rich and blessed with happiness, with love, and with peace, always within your hearts, within your home, and always within the world in which we live. my pleasure to announce, by the authority vested in me by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you are now husband and wife.